Hello, I'm Magdalena Simonis and we're going to talk today about fertility and the relationship between lifestyle, weight and fertility. And there are a few common scenarios that we'll be talking about today, and that is the one where either the female is overweight and presents for a general checkup or to talk about conception, and also the male on the occasion where he may well come in on his own. He's in an established relationship and you're talking to him about general health issues and then fertility and how general health can impact fertility. And also in the infertile couple who present together saying, you know, we've been trying for a while and we've not been successful. So when I talk to men about fertility, I usually do it in the context of their general health. Sometimes they might be presenting on their own for, you know, issues like, oh, my wife or my partner sent me in because, you know, she said that I need to be checked out because we have not conceived successfully so far. Or sometimes I do it in the context of the couple. Or opportunistically when I'm just following up on results with a patient who's in for a general checkup and they do have weight issues. I try and then relate it to how it might impact their fertility as a prompt to get them thinking about how this might be a motivator for them to lose weight. So I talk about in the context of their lifestyle, like what is it that you actually do throughout the day in terms of physical activity? Are you engaging in any sport? If so, what, how much? If not, why? And often people will say, or men will say, oh, look, you know, lifestyle, work, long hours, lots of after work functions, eating lots of the wrong things, alcohol almost with every function, travel, you know, travel interstate, stay in hotels with work. So we sort of look at what that really constitutes for them, and we talk about how we can actually modify what they select when they're eating so that that can actually encourage them to make a few better choices rather than just blatantly talking about diet. And I also talk very much about weight height ratio, the BMI, the body mass index. I help them understand what that implies. I help them see where they fit on the range and the spectrum, that, you know, 25 to 30 or 29.5 is, say, overweight, and 30 and over is considered obese. And many will find that very surprising because they don't consider themselves obese. And obese, the term, actually has many negative implications. So I try to sort of position it in a way that doesn't discourage them or disempower them. I just let them know that, look, you know, if you lost 5 kilos, that would actually shift your BMI into the other range. And that would actually also improve your fertility and your sperm count. So with a younger woman, let's say, when I see young women up until the age of 29, it's compulsory. Well, it's expected that we actually perform a screen for chlamydia. So I explain this to young people, women and men. Let's say if I'm with a young woman and we're performing an STI screen or a pap smear, I then also link up the issue of screening with long-term fertility. So I actually do explain to young women, look, the reason, and young men, that the reason that we're doing this is because undetected chlamydia is actually a common cause of infertility down the track, and that practicing safe sex is very important and coming back for follow-up is also very important if they have been detected as positive for these for this communicable disease and offer treatment. So certainly when they reach 26 or 28 and they've been in an established relationship for a long while and they're starting to look at, you know, talking about, you know, moving into motherhood or parenting, that's when we actually start to, I raise the discussion again around the 26 mark, you know, or where they've been in a relationship for a long while. I say, look, you know, have you and your partner talked about having children? When do you think that this might, you know, be a discussion that you have? And some will say, well, actually, I'm thinking about doing that when I'm about, you know, in another couple of years. So if it's in another couple of years, then that gives us that window of opportunity to actually improve on things. And I touch on issues like their weight, alcohol ingestion, smoking, and exercise. So where there is an issue regarding those, I address them and work at that with them. If they're overweight or obese, I say, well, look, you know, we're talking about healthy lifestyle and promoting your fertility, and there are ways that we can promote fertility. And I incorporate the weight discussion as a part of the overall discussion. So I don't center it around that, so that yet again, they're being told that they've got to lose weight, because they're hearing it from everyone and feeling it, no doubt. So I actually link it up to their fertility and say, well, you know, you don't need to lose too much weight to actually have an enormous impact on your ovulation, and that could be anything like 5% of your body weight, which might amount to something like 5 kilos overall. So it's not an enormous amount of weight, and that gives them that sort of little lift that you can almost see that, oh, if that's all I need to lose, then I'm going to make an effort. And I find that that's actually really a good way of introducing the discussion around weight and fertility.